Assalamualaikum semua. Hi, it's me again, Teacher Hafiza. Jadi, minggu ni kita nak belajar tentang present and past continuous tense. Apa tu present and past continuous tense? Itulah penggunaan ing dalam verbs. Kalau nak tahu lebih lanjut, teruskan menonton video ni.
So first of all, let's discuss the forms. Present continuous tense ditulis apabila am, is ataupun are diikuti dengan present participle verb. Manakala past continuous tense ditulis apabila verb was ataupun were diikuti dengan present participle verb. Jadi mungkin ada yang tertanya-tanya, teacher, apakah present participle verb? So present participle verb adalah base form yang diikuti dengan ing. Contoh base form apa? Perkataan seperti walk, berjalan, yang tidak ada tambahan lagi kan? So perkataan walk ni kita tambah dengan ing menjadi walking. Ha, itulah present participle verb. Next, let's discuss the uses of present and past continuous tense. Keyword untuk present continuous tense ialah sedang. Ha, sesuatu benda yang sedang berlaku. Jadi, kes pertama untuk menunjukkan actions that are happening or not happening right now. Ha. Second, longer actions that are currently in progress. Third, to illustrate events that are happening in the near future. So let's take a look at some of the examples. For the first case, I am drawing a picture. My father is jogging around the park. She is not listening to the radio. Jadi ketiga-tiga perbuatan ni sedang berlaku, right? Okay, second case. I am studying to become a lawyer. So, prosesnya adalah nak jadi lawyer. Dan sekarang apa dia tengah buat? Dia tengah belajar. Third case, they are moving into their new house next month. Jadi mereka ni sedang dalam proses untuk pindah rumah bulan depan. Sekejap lagi nak masuk dah. Now, for past continuous, pertama sekali, dia digunakan untuk menunjukkan an interruption in the past. Suatu gangguan yang berlaku di masa lalu. Kedua, untuk menunjukkan parallel actions. Let's take a look at examples. He was texting when the car came up from behind. Jadi, the interruption is kereta yang datang from behind. Kedua, at 8 PM last night, we were having dinner. Jadi, di situ, masa 8 PM last night tu dikira sebagai interruption. Seterusnya, while I was making dinner, he was reading the newspaper. Next, when I walked into the house, my mother was hanging the laundry while my siblings were watching television. So, ini adalah kes kedua bila dia nak menunjukkan dua actions sedang berlaku pada masa yang sama. Obviously, in past tense lah kan? Okay.
Alright, so that's all for today. I hope you understand the lesson. I'll see you soon in my FE Live videos. Bye!